Hi, my name is Cole from FCP Euro, and today I'm going to show you how to service your front differential or bevel box on your Mk8 Golf R. In front of us, we have the front differential service kit for the Mk8 Golf R. This kit is the liquid moly kit, and we offer this kit because it is a great fluid that is at a more affordable price point without sacrificing any quality. In this kit, we also include a drain and fill plug because they are one-time use and we're gonna have to replace those when we're doing the service. Not only do we offer a liquid moly service kit, we also offer a genuine kit that is listed on our website with a link posted in the description below if you're looking for genuine fluid for your vehicle. Now, as far as service intervals go, on the Mk8 Golf R with the locking differential, it's required to service the front differential every 3 years. There isn't a mileage interval, however, FCP Euro recommends every 30,000 miles on that. Now, if you have a non-locking front differential, there is no service interval from Volkswagen, but here at FCP Euro, we recommend changing that fluid every 10 years or 80 to 100,000 miles. Now, if you're wondering if you have a locking or non-locking differential on your Mk8, our catalog team has done all the hard work for you and assembled all the kits that are specifically applicable to your vehicle. And if you're unsure which kind of differential your Mk8 has, have no fear, give our customer service team a call with your VIN number and they'll be happy to help you to find that out. Now, if you're having noise come from your bevel box or having some kind of mechanical issue, this fluid service probably won't solve those problems because this is a maintenance item. Performing this service as a maintenance item will prolong the life of your front differential and have many more happy miles to come. Now that we've gone over all the parts in this kit, let's get into the tools we'll need for this DIY. Included in this service kit is CTA tool 7073, which is a fluid pump. Now, we'll also need a 5mm Allen key, a 1/4 inch extension, a 1/4 inch ratchet, and a 1/4 inch torque wrench to torque everything down. Not pictured, we're also gonna need a catch can to capture all the fluid from the differential. Now that we've gone over everything on the table, let's hop into this DIY. All right, so we have our vehicle safely lifted up in the air, and we're gonna start by cracking the fill plug and removing that and then pulling the drain plug. Now, we're gonna wanna use a set of safety glasses when working underneath the car because we are gonna be dealing with fluid and we would like to protect our eyeballs. So we have a 5mm Allen key right here on a nice 1/4 inch extension. And the fill plug is going to be up here on the bevel box, kind of tucked towards the back of it. So I can put my finger on it right there. Now, when going up to remove the fill plug, it is in a very tight spot. So we're gonna have to be cautious when inserting our 5mm Allen socket that it is all the way in. So we do not strip this out because trust me, it is not gonna be a fun time pulling this out if it is stripped. Once I have that Allen in, we're just gonna push very solid to make sure we have full engagement on that. Now we'll take our 1/4 inch ratchet, install it onto our socket, and crack this loose. Oh, there we go. Now once I have this cracked loose, we're gonna wanna be cautious because even though this is the fill plug, some fluid can come out. Now, with it being close to the end of the threads, it's always a good idea to pull the ratchet off, reposition yourself away from the line of drip, have a catch pan, and then remove it the rest of the way by hand. It is a little bit tight in here, so you may have to get your hand in here and use the finger method to remove the fill plug. Now that we have the fill plug removed, we can take that extension off of our ratchet and put the socket directly on the drain plug, which is right here. The reason why we're pulling that fill plug out first is so the vehicle has the ability to pull in air to then push out the fluid. If it's sealed, it'll come out a lot slower. Now, we're right at the end of the threads here, and a good little tip is to kind of just inch it all the way to the end, and then when you get really close, kind of quick movements, looking at the differential fluid coming out, it has a very nice color. It doesn't smell too burnt. And I would say this is in very good condition. Now, if it is a very dark color and it smells burnt, almost like clutch packs are burning, you may have gone a little too long in the service interval, and hopefully there's no catastrophic damage done to the clutch packs. We're gonna let this fluid drain out, and then we're gonna catch up back with you in a second. Now that our fluid is getting to a point where it's slowly dripping out of the bevel box, we can install our new drain plug with the seal that's encapsulated on here, thread it in by hand, snug it, and then torque it to 15 newton meters. With our 5mm Allen key, we're just coming back here and torquing this up to 15 newton meters. All right, this is all torqued to spec. We're just gonna take a little bit of brake clean and a paper towel and just make that nice and clean. All right, so this is the point where we're gonna crack this bottle of liquid moly gear oil open and start filling the bevel box. Volkswagen calls the front differential a bevel box as well. Now you'll see there's a little straw insert here. We won't be using that since we're using a fluid pump, so we can just get underneath here and remove it so we can install our syringe. Now using the CTA syringe that is provided in the kit, we'll just insert this into the bottle and slowly pull back on this plunger until the syringe is full. This gear oil has some resistance on it, so just be patient. Now with this syringe full, we can transfer all of this fluid inside of the bevel box. Now the capacity of this bevel box is going to be 0.9 liters. So to fill this, we'll just find our fill hole that we removed earlier. It is a little tight out here. May have to reposition to see it. And we're gonna wanna use the small hose adapter for this hole, cause it is quite tiny. All right. Once I'm in that hole, we're just gonna pump this fluid into the bevel box. It's gonna take a couple of these, but what we're trying to achieve here is filling this to the point where it starts dripping out of the fill hole, slow drip, and then we can reinstall with a new fill plug that has a gasket encapsulated in it. All right, we have some fluid dripping out here, and that's great. That's just what we want to see. Now we can pull this syringe out and let that drip out. Now that our fluid has come to a drip, very slow drip, we can take the new fill plug and thread it in by hand. All right. Now with that threaded in by hand, we can come back with our torque wrench and torque this to 15 newton meters. Once that fill plug's installed, we can come back with a little bit of brake clean and just wash this surface off. And that wraps it up. You just successfully serviced your bevel box slash differential on your Mk8 Golf. If you liked what you saw in this video, please be sure to hit that like button below. And if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, drop them in the comment section. We'll gladly answer them for you. If you want to see more content like this on the Mk8 and many other vehicles, be sure to subscribe because we have a lot more coming. My name's Cole from FCP Euro. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.